Okay, so today we're going to be engaging in a role play. The lesson is titled Homework, Harmful or Helpful. So I'm going to be modeling role play for you. Obviously, it's not going to be a 20-minute lesson. This can be done in 20 minutes. Seen it, done. Mine is longer because I want to engage you thoroughly in this notion of homework. And so you're due now. You were to write on your 3x5 card a homework assignment that you really like your favorite homework assignment. And that's just to get you thinking about homework and the kinds of homework that you have been engaged in. I'll point out here, this is going to be the homework as it relates to this role play, so I'll explain that in more detail later. Adhere to Teach 2 deadlines. Remember, you've got that calendar on D2L. And of course, I'd like to put the calendar up here for you. A week from today, there is no class. We have class Tuesday, but the Thursday before spring break, I'm going to Baltimore Tuesday night for a conference, so I will not be here. So no class a week from today, which is March 1st. Okay. So let's get started with the role play. I really like these keep calm phrases. That came out of World War II, didn't it, with Winston Churchill? Keep calm and carry on, I think it was the original. So I can't keep calm. There's too much homework. Do you guys feel like in college you have too much homework? I'm probably a culprit of that. Too much to do, right? I forgot my clicker today. Okay, so we're going to have four groups, and our numbers are small, and so some of you may end up working by yourself, and that's okay. I do have an English language learner, and my English language learner is at stage 5 acquisition, so she is able to understand English quite well, especially if I don't talk too fast. So if I talk too fast, please let me know. Also, her reading comprehension is quite good. What she struggles with, she can speak English, but that's her area that she struggles the most with. So there are, other than our word wall with some academic language, there are no translations because we're moving past that stage. But these are some new type words that you have not been exposed to. I have two gifted students, and they're right here, my two gifted students. They need extra challenge. They get through really quick, and they tend to get in trouble if they don't have meaningful, challenging work to do. And then I have a student over here that has severe headaches. And so I have to really watch, you know, for him and that he's doing okay. He's had an automobile accident, traumatic brain injury, recently back, and he's been suffering from some headaches. On him. Okay, so there are going to be four groups. So I will tell you which groups you are in a moment. So we're going to be watching a short video on Baltimore County Schools and their new homework policy. You'll see in the center of your table, you've got a couple things going on. First of all, in the very center, there's just some white paper that is yours if you want to take notes on. There's going to be note taking throughout. How you choose to take notes is up to you. I also have a marker out on each table because these words on the word wall are embedded in different articles that some of you will be reading. Not everyone's going to come across these words, but you may come across a word that in your reading when you are preparing for your role that you don't know or that you think, oh, this is a good word for the word wall. So I would ask that you write it large, and I've got some tape right here. We can put it up on the board. These words, if you come across it in your reading, then I'm going to ask that you write down the sentence just right next to it if you come across it so we see it in context, that word in context. Okay, so Baltimore County Schools, we're going to watch this video. And while you're watching this video, on your 3x5 card, I want you to write down sort of your thoughts on if you agree or disagree with what they're saying in this video. There's going to be a short ad. It's not closed caption. There are two times of Matthew McConaughey.
Those who fear the future and those who embrace it. The future is for them.
All the colors of the rainbow.
This will make me watch the whole thing. Can you hear that okay?
Yeah, it's back to school tomorrow in Baltimore County, but a new policy has some parents questioning whether their students will make the grade. WJZ's Live, Maggie McCorkle has more on the controversy. Maggie?
Well, Vic, this year students will be graded on what they learn, not how they behave in the classroom or if they turn in their homework. The backpacks are out.
I'm excited for kindergarten.
Students in Baltimore County celebrating Wednesday's return to school.
What's your favorite part about going to school?
I'm playing the toys.
Though it's not all fun and games.
You gonna do all your homework?
Yes. But this year, completing homework won't count into a student's grade.
I heard of it, but I thought it was a joke.
According to a new policy, marking period grades will be based solely on achievements and grade level standards. Classroom conduct, homework completion, and ability to work with others will be assessed in a separate section of the report card, but won't impact grades.
Personally, I don't like it because it feels like they're lowering the standards for the students. Homework is A+. It must be done.
The school system has released a video to explain the new grading system to parents.
Starting this school year, all student grades will align to identified course or grade level standards.
The new grading system was formed by a committee of parents, teachers, and administrators who found punishing students for missed homework didn't motivate them to work harder. Some say they backed the new system.
It's good, because I feel though, you know, a lot of times they probably wouldn't do it by themselves anyway.
Others say, policy or not,
he'll be turning in his homework regardless,
whether it counts or not.
Megan, thank you. And for a link to the new grading policy, check out our website.
Okay, so I would like for you to write down your thoughts about, you know, whether you agree, disagree on that 3x5 card. You're just going to hang on to that card for a minute. I'm going to have you two work together in your role as the student, okay? And don't write on this sheet. That gives a little bit of summary. You may want to move closer together. This is the article that you're going to read. You can mark on your article, okay? Bill, you're going to be the principal. So don't write on your principal sheet there, because I'm going to reuse those. Mm-hmm. But you can Yeah, they'll write on the character sheet this afternoon. And then you all are the teacher, so put right on the character sheet. But there are two articles here, and these are longer articles, and I have identified that what to focus on. You all. And then for Kenneth, you are the parent. And so don't write on your student for that character sheet. And then here is your article. Okay, so everyone has a role, and I will explain what you are to do. You will find on your, thank you for reminding me. I want to have you look up here for a second. So Baltimore County Schools, so this is the dilemma. In a role play, there's a dilemma. Baltimore County Schools, this is fictional. Overland High School within Baltimore County Schools is having some backlash at this new proposal regarding homework. And so in a public hearing, principal, parents, teacher, and students have come together to voice their opinions. And I'm going to be the moderator of this meeting. But we've got to prepare for the meeting. So you will find on your table slides that I've turned over that look like this. So you always have the dilemma in front of you. There's one here and one here. And then we can change this sheet because we're getting ready to go over our learning targets. So if you want a visual of learning targets, that's going to be next. So you can refer to these slides if you're not certain about, you know, you want to check back on certain things. So our learning targets today are, I can explain four different viewpoints. So what do you think those four viewpoints are that we're going to be looking at? Exactly. Principal, teacher, student, and parent. So you're going to be able to explain all four of those roles. And then as a homework assignment, I can create my own philosophy of homework. So you've already written down on your 3x5 card your thinking right now. And we're going to go through this role play. And you may not agree with the role that you're playing with, but I'm going to ask you that you sort of take on that persona. And it's going to be rooted in literature and this character sheet where I've given you some basic information. But what you're going to do is skim through the articles there, giving you little characters. And you're going to build an argument. Because what we're looking at is this driving question. Should homework be assigned? And if it's assigned, should it count for a grade? So some people say it shouldn't be assigned at all. Some folks say, well, if it is assigned, it should not count for a grade. And that's basically the argument that you're going to be building. So to prepare for your role, you have articles. Some have one article, some have two articles. Some folks are by themselves, but I know that you're very capable of working alone. So on the white paper that's in front of you, that's a good place for you to sort of build that character, build based on the literature. So when it's time for the role play, the enactment, I'm going to call on people to come forward. Of course, we only have one principal and one parent, so you guys will be it. And you need to be able to explain your view rooted in literature. Okay? Do you have questions?
What is an effect size?
Okay, good question. So that would be a word that we need to write here. And an effect size is a statistical measure that allows us to determine the impact that something has on something else. So an effect size of 1 is high. An effect size of 0.4 in teaching, in education realm, is like average mediocre. So anything above 0.4 in effect size is good stuff. And I'll be happy to, I'll take that up there for you. So I'm going to give you 10 minutes to skim through your article, take your notes. I will come around checking on you to see if you need any help, and we'll go from there. Set, go. Yeah. Thanks. Okay. you have a chance to skim through your articles, then you'll need to have some dialogue for those of you that have talked about it. I'm going to stop this and remind me to start again.